Namaste, my name is Mahesh. In this video, I would like to explain about velocity, uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, average velocity, instantaneous velocity, acceleration, uniform acceleration, non-uniform acceleration, average acceleration and instantaneous of acceleration. These are the side headings I would like to cover in this video. First, I shall explain point to point. After that, I can explain on the board. Please observe carefully. Okay? First, our concept is velocity. Now, I would like to explain about first velocity. The rate of change of displacement is called velocity. It is a vector quantity. The units are meter per second. Our second concept is uniform velocity. If a body covers a displacement, of uniform with equal interval of time, such a velocity we call as uniform velocity. In other words, if a body covers equal displacements in equal interval of time, such a velocity we call as uniform velocity. Non-uniform velocity, our next concept is non-uniform velocity. If a body covers equal displacements with unequal interval of time or unequal displacements with equal interval of time, such a velocity we call as non-uniform velocity. Next, our concept is average velocity. The average velocity, which can be defined as, it is the total distance by total time taken by the object, is called average velocity. Now I can explain one by one slowly on the board. Please observe carefully. Point number one, velocity. The time rate of change of displacement an object in a particular direction is called the velocity of the object. Okay? It is the vector quantity. The unit is meter per second. Next one. Uniform velocity. If an object undergoes equal displacement in equal interval of time, then it is said to be moving with uniform velocity. Okay? Next of our concept is non-uniform velocity. If an object undergoes unequal displacements with equal interval of time, then it is said to be moving with a non-uniform velocity. The another name is variable velocity. Or A, an object undergo equal displacements with unequal interval of time, then also we call as non-uniform velocity or variable velocity. Next, average velocity. The ratio of total displacement to the total time taken by an object is called the average velocity of the object. Therefore, the average velocity is velocity, uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity and average velocity. Please copy in your notes. Now I want to explain about instantaneous velocity. When an object is traveling with variable velocity, then its velocity at given instant of time is called instantaneous velocity, which can be defined as V is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta r by delta t. That is equal dr by dt. Next, acceleration. The rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. In other words, the time rate of change of velocity of an object is called the acceleration of the object. It is a vector quantity. Okay. Next, uniform acceleration. An object is said to be moving with uniform acceleration if its velocity changes by equal amounts in equal interval of time is called uniform acceleration. Next, non-uniform acceleration. An object is said to be moving with non-uniform acceleration or variable acceleration if its velocity changes by unequal amounts in equal interval of time is called non-uniform acceleration. Next concept is average acceleration. If a body travels with uniform acceleration A1 and A2 in time T1 and T2, then the average acceleration can be written as AV is equal to A1 T1 plus A2 T2 by T1 plus T2. Okay. Next, instantaneous acceleration. Acceleration at any instant of time is known as instantaneous acceleration. That is, A is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta v by delta t. That is equal delta v by delta t. Okay. Next, two important points I would like to raise in this video. What are that? Point number one. If the velocity of an object decreases with time, its acceleration is called negative or retardation or deceleration. Next, second point. Velocity and acceleration of an object need not be zero simultaneously. This is also one of the important points. These are the important points I would like to cover in this video. Now, I can explain on the board. Please observe carefully. Now, instantaneous velocity. When an object is traveling with variable velocity, then its velocity at a given instant of time is called as instantaneous velocity. Therefore, instantaneous velocity V is equal limit delta t comes to 0 delta r by delta t. That is equal dr by dt. Okay. Next, acceleration. the time rate of change of velocity of an object is called the acceleration of the object. It is a vector quantity. The unit is meter per second square. Okay. Next our concept is uniform acceleration. An object is said to be moving with uniform acceleration. If its velocity changes by equal amount in equal interval of time, such a movement we call as uniform acceleration. Okay. Next our concept is non-uniform acceleration and average acceleration. Next our concept is non-uniform acceleration and average acceleration. Up to that, please copy this one. Now we are going to discuss about non-uniform acceleration and average acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration. An object is said to be moving with non-uniform acceleration or variable acceleration if its velocity changes by unequal amounts in equal interval of time is called non-uniform acceleration. Okay. Next, average acceleration. If a body travels with uniform acceleration A1 and A2 in time T1 and T2, then the average acceleration can be written as AB is equal AT1 plus AT2 by T1 plus T2. Okay, that is average acceleration. Our next is instantaneous acceleration. Okay. Now our topic is instantaneous acceleration. What is instantaneous acceleration? The acceleration at any instant of time is known as instantaneous acceleration. Once again, the acceleration at any instant of time is known as instantaneous acceleration. Therefore, A is equal in delta t tends to 0, delta t by delta t, that is equal dt by dt. This is important. Please note down. Next, two important points I would like to write in this video. What are that? If the velocity of an object decreases with time, if the velocity of an object decreases with time, its acceleration is known as negative acceleration. Its acceleration is negative. That is negative of acceleration we call as negative acceleration or retardation or deceleration. Okay. Next, velocity of acceleration of an object. Meet all in zero simultaneously. I can give an example. If an object Please note down these important points with your beautiful handwriting in your book notes. Okay? Anyhow, thank you very much for watching this video. Thanks a lot.